The following video is for entertainment purposes only, and maybe some travel information. The paranormal can be neither proven nor disproven, and as such, take everything I say and do with a grain of salt. The purpose of this channel is, and always has been, to inspire people to go ghost hunting and experience it for themselves. Now sit back and enjoy the video, traveler.
The Hotel Indigo, Birmingham, Alabama, 5 points south. This charming Art Deco building features clean and comfortable rooms, incredible water, as well as a private restaurant that offers a breakfast package with your stay, providing you with a 5-star experience at a 4-star price. But is it haunted? In 20 minutes or less. Greetings, travelers. Once again, it is I, the Reverend Victor S. Johnson, and I've been places you've only read about. This, as always, is my co-host and producer, Dudley, and boy, do we have a great one for you tonight. But first, please remember to like and subscribe.
And traveler, I need to talk to you about a sudden but under-the-radar evil that we all experience at one time or another. That's right, the demon of boredom. Traveler, have you ever been disappointed after a ghost hunt? You sat there for hours, and your REM pod didn't REM, and your swizzle sticks didn't swizzle, and what's more, your pendulum didn't pend. Well, what do you do now? You drove for hours, and you've got nothing going on tomorrow. Well, let's vanquish that demon of boredom together. Let me introduce you to Viator. Viator is an experience booking app that works all over the world. It links up travelers just like you and I with tour guides like myself. And it's got it all. Ghost tours, helicopter tours, escape room experiences, taste testings, and even Segway tours like I used to give, all over the country. Well, wouldn't you know it, I've worked with Viator in the past as a guide and now as an affiliate. That's right, I've got my own Viator shop, and I have personally curated experiences all over the country for you and your fellow travelers to peruse. So check it out. I have a special list for Alabama that I put together after Dudley and I stopped in Huntsville and Birmingham. So check out Viator today and vanquish the demon of boredom for good. And remember to take your tour with Viator. You like that, Dudley? I just thought of that. Well, let's see you come up with something better. Anyway, my Viator shop is in the description. Now on with the video.
So, traveler, Dudley and I had some time to ourselves in July, and we decided it's very, very inexpensive to fly into Nashville, Tennessee, which is what we did. But funny enough, we never actually saw the city limits of Nashville. Once we left the airport and picked up the car, we had much to do. See, Nashville seems like a good town, but it is very, very expensive, way outside of our budget. Then we found out about Birmingham, Alabama, and the Hotel Indigo at 5 points south. And not only was it a beautiful and affordable hotel, it has a reputation of being haunted. Built in the 1930s, this building, nearly 100 years old, served as a medical complex mixed with an artist collective. You gotta love that bohemian style. Eventually, this became a hotel near the heart of the 5 Points South intersection. In old photos, you can actually see the old medical arts building, traveler, looking over what is now Pickwick Plaza. As for the ghosts, Haunted Places tells a tale of a nurse in the medical arts building era roaming around the 8th floor checking up on guests under the guise that they are new patients. Haunted Rooms dives a bit deeper. In addition to the nurse sightings, the website mentions several different kinds of apparitions or phenomena, cold spots, feelings of being watched, and, what's more, the basement where the fitness center is, used to be a morgue at a point. Because why not? Odd odors can often be detected all over the hotel. A little girl might haunt the lobby as she plays a game of jacks in another time. And former guests and partygoers can be seen all over the hotel, maybe even appearing in your room. Now, before we get into the ghost hunt portion of the video, Traveler, I wanted to take a moment to review the hotel. The staff was friendly, the bed was amazing, the water felt great on my skin, and the breakfast was the best breakfast I could have got in Birmingham. I had French toast and yogurt with fruit. With that out of the way, let's see what Dudley and I came up with. This is our ghost hunt. And remember, the paranormal can be neither proven nor disproven. Take all of this with a grain of salt. Hello. Is there anyone in here with me right now? Please feel free to speak into the recorder or make either of the devices on the table light up or respond. Is there anyone at all? I'll give you another opportunity. And then I'm going to try something else. Were you a male? Can you try making that device on the right light up again? Just for the control, were you a female? Okay, we're going to try something else. Give me a moment. Okay, is anyone here with us right now? Please feel free to talk into the white noise. Please feel free to talk into the white noise. Was that good morning? Good morning, if it was. Can you tell me your name? Can you tell me a little about yourself? Please feel free to talk into the white noise. My name is Victor. I'd like to know yours. Did you say Steve? Can you confirm if that was Steve? Can you respond with yes? Maybe Steven. Okay, well, good morning, Steven. Do you have anything else you'd like to tell us? You can please feel free to try, Steven. I mean you no harm. I'm just curious to learn more. But it's okay if you don't. Steven, I'm gonna give this another minute. And if I've misidentified you, can you please give me a second name? If not, that's okay. Steven, I'm going to give you 30 more seconds, okay? Say whatever you want. This is a freestyle, so whatever you have for me, feel free to say it. Okay, I'm going to shut off the white noise now. We'll try something else. Is there anyone in here with me right now? Cross the dowsing rods if yes, and leave them uncrossed if not. Hello, Spirit, and good morning. Spirit, can you take my dowsing rods and point to where you are in the room at this time? It's always a corner. Spirit, please reset my dowsing rods. That means bring them both back to my shoulder. And the left one, please. Thank you. Spirit, were you born of male? Can you please cross the dowsing rods if yes? Leave them uncrossed if no. Good morning, sir. Is your name Stephen? Can you leave the dowsing rods crossed if yes, and uncross them if no? Stephen, did you die in the hotel? Leave the rods crossed if yes, uncross them if no. Stephen, did you die in Birmingham? Can you cross the rods back if yes? Uncross them if no. Stephen, did you have great memories at this hotel? Can you cross the rods if yes? And leave them uncrossed if no. Stephen, did you live a long life? Can you uncross the rods if no? Cross the rods if yes. Stephen, did you die of illness? Can you cross the rods if yes? Leave them uncrossed if no. By the way, travelers, my K2 just went off to yellow for the first time. I'm sorry your life was cut down, Stephen. Was it an epidemic that killed you? Can you leave the rods crossed if yes, or uncross them if no? Stephen, are you happy here? Can you cross the rods if yes, and leave them uncrossed if no? Well, I'm glad. Stephen, I'm going to release you at this time. We both need to eat breakfast. So please release my dowsing rods, one after the other. You can pull them both to my shoulders, I release you. I say goodbye, spirit. Thank you for speaking with me today. The gate is closing. Goodbye, Stephen. I really am glad you enjoyed it. So there you have it, traveler. Truly an amazing experience at a wonderful hotel. I really did mean it when I said to Steve that I hope he's enjoying the afterlife. And for all of our sakes, I only hope that the rest of us can be so lucky after we pass on. But as for right now, as always, Dudley and I must be moving on. So once again, I am the Reverend Victor S. Johnson. This, as always, is Dudley. And safe travels, traveler.